Adding immunizations. The Forecast tab is the third tab on the main screen. It contains the results of the Sky Registry Forecast Wizard and displays recommended vaccines that are due or late based on the patient's current age and immunization history known to the registry. Periodically, you may need to select the Refresh option in order for the Forecast Wizard to display updated recommendations. Remember, the immunization forecast is a resource tool. It does not replace your clinical assessment of the patient's immunizations. Next, the Immunization tab displays all the patient's immunizations that have been entered into the registry. Since John Test was just added into the registry, there is no immunization history known at this time. To complete your patient's immunization history, you will use the Historical Quick Entry tool located under the Tools menu option and select Historical Quick Entry. The Historical Quick Entry screen is used to enter immunization histories of shots administered by other immunization providers. It is highly recommended that all historical shots are entered into the registry first to assess the immunization needs of your patient. The Historical Provider Facility field will automatically default to Historical Provider Facility. You will also have the option to select your facility's location for entering previously administered vaccines. For example, vaccines administered prior to having the registry may be entered using this option. The Vaccine Name field defaults to the short list. The short list contains a list of vaccines that are most frequently administered. You may also view vaccines from the long list, which contains all currently available vaccines, or the obsolete list, which contains discontinued vaccines. Select the appropriate vaccine from the drop-down menu, or you may begin typing the vaccine name to populate in the field. In this example, HPV has been selected. Proceed to list the vaccination dates in the blank boxes to the right. Dates must be grouped by series, and each series of dates are to be on the same row. Watch as John's vaccination history is being entered into the registry. To begin a new row of blank fields, click the Insert Row button from the bottom of the screen. MCV4 is selected and the date entered to the right. Again, click the Insert Row button for a new row. Next, Tdap is entered with the date on the right. Once all the dates are entered into John's chart, review the information to make sure no errors were made. If an extra row of blank fields are left on the page, click on the minus and the row will be deleted. The scroll bar can be used to navigate data within the Historical Quick Data Entry screen. To delete all data from this page, you may select the Clear All Data button. For example, when vaccines are entered into the chart for the wrong patient. Click Save and all the vaccination dates are entered from the Historical Quick Entry tool and can be viewed on the Immunization tab. Once the historical vaccines are entered, administered vaccine information can be entered by selecting the Add button located at the lower left of the screen. After selecting the Add button, the immunization entry screen will appear. New vaccine data can be entered in this screen, allowing you to document details on vaccine doses. In the lower portion of the screen, the Forecast Snapshot is a smaller view of the Forecast tab. The Immunization Snapshot is a smaller view of the Immunization tab. The Patient's Identifying Information bar displays the MCI number, name, date of birth, and age. All yellow fields are required to enter vaccines into the immunization registry. Entry type defaults to administered. These are shots given by your facility. Historical vaccines are shots given by another facility. Administered is selected. Next, the vaccine name drop-down menu defaults to the short list, which contains the most frequently administered vaccines. You may also choose from the long list, which contains all currently available vaccines, or the obsolete list, which contains vaccines that are discontinued. Hepatitis A is selected. The vaccination date field defaults to the current date. If the vaccine was not entered on the date administered, it can be entered by typing a two-digit month, two-digit day, and four-digit year. Slashes must be added. Click within the data field to select a month, year, and day to populate the date in the field. Remember, vaccines must be entered within 10 days of being administered. The provider facility defaults to your location. The vaccine type is only mandatory when patients are less than 19 years of age and the entry type is listed as administered. From the drop-down menu, select the appropriate vaccine type. Pediatric private insured is selected. The fields on the right are optional and data entry is strongly encouraged. Federal law requires that vaccines administered must be fully documented in the patient's permanent medical chart. Your practice may want to print the data entered here and retain a copy of the immunization information sheet for the patient's medical chart. From the drop-down menu, select your administration site. Here, left arm is selected. Administration route, intramuscular is selected. The manufacturer fields default to the short list, which contains the most commonly used manufacturers. The long list contains all manufacturers, and the obsolete list contains companies that are no longer manufacturing vaccines. GSK is selected from the short list. Enter in your manufacturer's lot number. The administered by field will contain the names of authorized shot givers within your practice. The name of the person who administered the vaccine should appear in this field and can be obtained from the drop-down menu. Note the red warning to please verify this entry's information before proceeding. Certain information cannot be changed. The VIS date field automatically populates for administered vaccines and it reflects the most current available VIS statement. The VIS statement given to the patient should reflect that date. Selecting the Insert button will store data and reset fields for another entry. The Cancel Exit option closes a screen. Any data entered is not saved. Select Save and all of the vaccination information can be viewed from the Immunization tab.